ladies and gentlemen, in the next fight of the evening, please welcome to the blue corner, Lucien Phillips.
All right, so here it is, our fourth fight of the evening. Coming out first from Regina, fighting out of Elite MMA, Lucien Phillips.
Yeah, Lucien's one of another one of Jeff Wiley's guys. Jeff Wiley brought a big crew out here. Years old, so he's a little more mature fighters of the evening.
Making his MMA debut at that age, and it seems like every Rumble in the Cage, you do have someone in their 30s making their debut in mixed martial arts, and it's a sport for the young, but it's also a sport for everyone almost.
Yeah, I mean, MMA hasn't been around that long if you think about it, and now it's becoming more and more popular. More and more people want to step in and give it a try. And there's more and more opportunities. I mean, like Rumble in the Cage has been around for over a decade. But back then, there weren't that many promotions around. Now in Canada, I mean, in Alberta alone, there's over a dozen organizations putting on fights. If you're a fight fan, you could be at any fight card in Alberta, or any weekend and be at a fight card within an hour drive, I bet you.
Yeah, and it just goes to show how many gyms there are out there now, and people who've been in the sport, and it's like a tree, right? You know, you get people training with different people, the cross-pollination of thoughts and ideas, and I mean, it's not just for people who want to get in the cage.
In the red corner, Shane Erickson.
It's a fitness activity now done by thousands and thousands of people here in Canada.
Quite the analogy, Marty.
Well, I know you like to train some people up yourself, so.
Absolutely.
Coming out, a guy you should be familiar with from PDV Martial Arts in Calgary, Alberta. He'll be making his cage debut this evening, Shane Erickson.
Yeah, I'm quite familiar with Shane. Shane's one of my favorite guys up in Calgary to spar with. He's a kid likes to bang. I can hit him as hard as I want. Maybe not as hard as I want. But, you know, I can bang with him. He'll give it back. He's definitely a game fighter. He's a very hard worker, so. Yeah. I'm excited to see this guy fight. I'm also excited to see what Lucien brings to the cage. Again, both fighters' first fight. Nerves come into play. The conditioning, the preparation. I learned a ton from my first fight. I learned that I had to start working harder because it's a lot harder than it looks in there. I like Shay's philosophy to winning is swing hard. The deep thinker, that Shay.
Swing hard and connect, I would suggest, because swinging hard in itself isn't quite enough.
Lucien Phillips has the best job in the world, I'd have to say. He's a stay-at-home dad. One day I'll sign up for that job.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next fight is brought to you by Flamin' Fitness. It'll be contested at 155-pound weight division, and it is an amateur bout over 2 5-minute rounds. And now first, introducing in the blue corner, fighting out of the Wiley team in Regina, Saskatchewan. Tonight he makes his cage debut. He weighed in at 155 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Lucien Phillips. And in the red corner, fighting out of BDB Martial Arts in Calgary, Alberta. He also makes his cage debut. He also weighed in at 155 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Shane Erickson.
This is Rumble in the Cage 42 coming to you from Lethbridge, Alberta. It is our fourth fight of the evening at 155 pounds. Lucien Phillips fighting out of Regina, Elite MMA. He's in the black trunks with white and red trim, the Maple Leaf, fighting BDB Calgary's Shay Erickson, 24 years of age, 5'10". He's 155 pounds. He's also wearing black trunks.
Both fighters look pretty relaxed out there, coming out, feeling each other out.
Huge right hand, though, by Erickson. Drops Phillips, and he's got him in some trouble. This one might end early.
Yeah, that was a huge right by Shay. Dropped Erickson right on his back.
Our referee, Elvis Lyon, having a close look, but it looks like Phillips will survive that opening barrage by Erickson.
Yeah, good job. Good job by the referee to sit there and know that that Phillips was still safe in there and take a little bit more punishment.
He's got half guard going now.
Yeah, Shea should stay in half guard. Work the elbows from here. Attack the body. Just stay busy. He's not in really any danger from being guillotined from this position.
Erickson trying to work his head free, though, nonetheless. About a minute into this fight. Phillips now trying to sink it in.
Yeah, Shea's got to start framing off Phillips' head, cross-facing him. Make some space so he can get his chin out of there. Create more space so he can attack with the elbows and punches.
Couple of crunching body blows by Erickson. He's almost free now.
Yeah, he's got his chin out there. He's going to pull his head like that.
And he continues to punish the body of Phillips. And now up top to the head. Phillips kicks away and gets back to his feet. Good scramble. But Erickson relentless in his attack. But now Phillips presses him up against the cage.
You can definitely see the experience of the Muay Thai background of Shea. Phillips doesn't want to stand. Probably remembering that first punch in the first opening seconds.
So now it's Phillips trying to get Erickson to the mat, perhaps.
Nice reversal.
The switch by Erickson. A standing guillotine attempt, perhaps.
Yeah, I can't tell if Erickson's got his arm under his chin. Looks like Phillips' head's going to pop out of there pretty easy, though.
Oh. Or not. That is a tap out.
I saw a tap.
That is a tap out. Shea Erickson with an impressive submission, a standing guillotine.
Yeah, that guillotine surprised me. I thought that Phillips' head was just about to pop out there, and then Shea Erickson lifted him up by his neck and got the tap.
It looked like perhaps he was almost free, relaxed just a little bit, and that was the opening that Shea Erickson needed to end this. Here's the big right hand right off the open that got Phillips onto the mat.
Yeah, Shea just unloaded with a barrage of punches, and like I said, good job by the referee to tell that Phillips was still safe in there. Phillips did a good job, kept his composure and protected himself.
And Shea Erickson making his debut here in very impressive fashion at Rumble in the Cage 42. And here's a look at the end. Tremendous strength there, Jay.
Shea just cranked on that. I mean, like I said, it surprised me. I don't know how Shea kept Lucien's hair. I keep saying Lucien. It is Lucien.
You're right.
Lucien's head in there. Why ever should I correct myself? I'm always right.
More times than not, Keith Crawford, a man who's always right, will have the official announcement in the cage.
Ladies and gentlemen, two athletes making their cage debut. Let's hear it for them one more time. Referee Elvis Lyons steps in at 2:20 of the very first round. Your winner by tap out, guillotine, Shea Erickson.
So a nice debut for Team BDB member from Calgary, Shea Erickson, gets a guillotine choke submission victory over Lucien Phillips. He showed some heavy hands, and then he showed that he could finish it as well.
Yeah, I mean, Shea's a well-rounded guy. Has a kickboxing background. Came out, showed that, BDB guys are well-rounded. This is one of the guys that we've kind of been wanting to see fight for a while, and this just happened to be the perfect time for him to make his debut.